Good morning. I am Brenda, the secretary to Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela has been elected the first black president of South Africa, and it is his first day at office. He realizes that the white staff is moving out, so he immediately calls for a meeting.
Brenda, please assemble all the staff.
Yes, sir.
I like you to wait out here.
But Madiba,
I can't talk to them hiding behind you with the guns.
I can't notice all the empty offices and the packed boxes when I came to work this morning. Now, of course, if you want to leave, that is your right. And if you feel from your heart that you cannot work with your new government, it is better that you leave right away. But if you are packing up because you fear that the language or the color of your skin or who you worked for before disqualifies you from working here, I'm here to tell you, have no such fear. The past is the past. We look to the future now. We need your help. We want your help. Are you with me?
We need more men.
Did you talk to Brenda?
Yes, yesterday. What's this?
Who is Jason Jibalala?
That's me. Am I under arrest?
Captain Ferdinand reporting for duty, sir.
What duty?
For the presidential bodyguard. We have been assigned to this office. Here are the orders.
Just wait here.
You look agitated, Jason.
That's because there are 4 special branch cops in my office.
Ah, yes. What did you do then?
Nothing. They say they are presidential bodyguards and they have orders signed by you.
Ah, yes. These men are specially trained and they have a lot of experience.
Doesn't mean they
You asked for more men, didn't you?
Yes, sir. But
when people see me in public places, they see my bodyguards. You represent me directly. The Rainbow Nation starts here. Reconciliation starts here.
Reconciliation, sir?
Yes, reconciliation, Jason.
Comrade President, don't you remember these guys tried to kill us? Maybe even these 4 guys in my office tried and often succeeded.
Yes, I know. Forgiveness starts here too. Forgiveness liberates the soul. It removes the fear. That's why it is such a powerful weapon. Please, Jason, try.
It's 1995 and South Africa is hosting the Rugby World Cup. Springbok is the rugby team representing South Africa and were previously considered the team of white South Africa. The blacks are against Springboks as it is a symbol of apartheid. So they dissolve it unanimously. Mandela doesn't like this, so he decides to change this by speaking to them.
Let's rush to the club. I must address the members.
But the prior appointments.
Cancel them.
We should at least include the sports minister.
No.
I strongly advise against taking decisions on your own.
Your advice is duly noted.
But Madiba, they hate the Springboks. They don't want to be represented by this team.
Yes, I know. But in this instance, people are wrong. And as their elected leader, it is my responsibility to show them that. See. Brothers, sisters, comrades, I believe we should restore the Springboks. Restore their name, their emblem, and their color immediately. Let me tell you why. On Robben Island, in Portsmouth prison, all my jailers were the Afrikaners. For 27 years, I studied them. I had to know my enemy before I could prevail against him. And we did prevail, did we not? Our enemy is no longer the Afrikaner. They are our fellow South Africans, our partners in democracy. And they treasure the Springbok rugby. If we take that away, we lose them. We prove we are what they feared we would be. We have to be better than that. We have to surprise them with compassion, restraint, and with generosity. I know all the things they denied us. But now, this is no time for petty revenge. This is the time to build our own nation using each and every brick available to us. You elected me your leader. Let me lead you now. Who's with me?
Mandela places his support to Springbok and calls the captain to meet him at his office. Mandela tries to discuss the strategy of the rugby team through which he plans to build the nation and bring his divided people together.
Thanks for coming all this way, Captain.
My pleasure, sir.
How's your ankle? I was told it was hurt. Has it healed?
Yes, sir.
Please have a seat. You have a very difficult job, Captain.
Do I?
Yes, Captain of Springboks. A very difficult job.
Not compared to yours, President.
Well, what is your philosophy of leadership? How do you inspire your team to do their best?
By example. I have always thought to lead by example, sir.
That is exactly right. But now to get them better than they think they could be, that is very difficult. How do we inspire everybody around us? Sometimes I think by using the work of others. On Robben Island, when things got very bad, I found inspiration in a poem. Just words. But they helped me to stand. Well, all I wanted to do was just to lie down.
On the day of the match, in the bus, on the way to the stadium, nobody talks.
Ah, yes. They are all preparing.
Right. But when I think we are ready, I ask the bus driver to put on a song. Something I've chosen. One we all know. And we listen to the words together. And it helps.
Yes, I remember. In 1992 Olympics in Barcelona, everybody in the stadium greeted me with a song. At the time, the future, our future seemed very bleak. But to hear the song in the voices of people all around the world made me very proud to be a South African. It helped me to go home and do better. It allowed me to expect more of myself.
May I ask you, what was the song, sir?
It was a very inspiring song. We need inspiration transfer. Because in order to build our own nation, we must all exceed our expectations.
Oh. out of the night that covers me, black as a pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the frail clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludging of chance, my head is bloody but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears, looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with the punishments the scroll, I am the master of my fate, I am the captain of my soul. I am the master of my fate, I am the captain of my soul. I am the master of my fate, I am the captain of my soul. I am the master of my fate, I am the captain of my soul.